The village is at the end of a dirt road, not far from Jericho on the West Bank. Desert surrounds it. There's no electricity, it all comes from solar panels. And the village's gas comes from a recently installed anonymous white box. It produces biogas, and while the process is not new and is widely used around the world already, it's never been done by an ultra-simple and cheap machine like this. This bucket contains animal waste. Now all I have to do is add water and mix it very thoroughly. Then you pour the mixture into the machine, and you just have to wait until it makes its way to the bottom. From this organic waste, the machine makes cooking gas, enough to power a stove for 2 hours every day. Before the machine arrived, villagers had to cook with firewood. When we cooked before, it made a lot of smoke. It smelt bad and it could be dangerous. Because when it rained, you had to make the fires indoors. And it took a lot of time. Now we have a flame when we want it. All you need is a little spark. The machine was designed in Israel by a Palestinian engineer, Amar Rabaya, who's busy installing it in remote villages all over the West Bank.
The main idea, when the manure goes inside the system, it goes for the stomach of the system. This stomach, it's the same, the stomach of the human being. So it goes there, the bacteria is there, then the bacteria start eating the manure, and it will produce gas, and it goes directly to the home.
Making gas from waste products is not revolutionary, but until now, machines have been large and difficult to build and supply. This machine comes in a small box in kit form, and can be assembled at home.
We invented a way of taking the biogas technology into every home. Today we understand that waste is a source of energy, and that's changed the whole rules of the game. If we can see the benefits on the waste and not treating the waste just as waste, it changes everything.
At a cost of a little over 500 euros and easy to set up, these biogas generators are already up and running in 100 homes in Israel. Homes like Karin and Omer's, a young vegan couple, very into ecology. I've got carrots, potatoes, greens and cereals here. I try and use cereals in all my dishes. As Karin and Omer only eat vegetables every day, they produce buckets of vegetable waste. But this is also excellent fuel for biogas. But what interests them above all is the machine's other product. Top quality fertilizer. This is where the byproduct of gas production comes out, and in fact it's fertilizer that we can use for seeding plants and trees. On his plot of land opposite his house, Omer has a kitchen garden, an on-the-doorstep supply of food, and now fuel for his machine. It's a complete cycle, a closed circuit, and for me that's very important. It means a number of jobs no one wants to do are eliminated. Like, for example, looking after dustbins and managing rubbish. We don't need to do that anymore. It's the same story for fertilizer. It's expensive and needs to be brought in. Now it's available here. It's very satisfying because it gives you the feeling you're helping to make the world a better place. This Israeli startup is about to go to the market for funds to make the machine more widely available, and the makers are hoping for a favorable response from consumers.